Hey everyone, I'm coming to you from Siege Athletics in Mineola. Thank you, Noah Siegel, for having me in today. It's fantastic here, having a great time. Can't wait to get back to the gym. So talking about some basic cardio modalities I like to implement in for myself and for my clientele, okay? So we have, you know, a powerless treadmill, which I really enjoy utilizing because it's not, you don't have this flywheel, this belt constantly moving on its own, where what I'm finding with a lot of runners is that the second our foot hits that belt, it's ripping our foot back. It's putting our lower back into extension. And I feel like that's a lot of the reasons why you see runners on treadmills constantly tightening their hips. They're not utilizing the strength of their glute as much, okay? Their posterior chain as much. And they're just getting that low back into that overstretched position, that extended position, and which is forcing a lot of tightness in the hip flexor and weakness in the glute. So that's why I normally recommend a motorless treadmill. Probably one of the best modalities that I use a lot at my club would be an assault trainer. I use an Aerodyne bike by Schwinn. I get it from Perform Better. It's a great piece. This is awesome as well, but this is a very safe way for you to be able to put a client or yourself onto something that is very space friendly. It's very cost efficient in my opinion. It's portable. Like, you can literally grab the back end of this and just start wheeling it around. It weighs absolutely nothing, and you can demand a lot out of your body. Where, say, running takes a high level of athleticism, in my opinion. You're always worrying about it. Maybe a new client hopping on a motorless treadmill to where there is balance or there is other variables that are gonna go on besides what your main focus is right now, and that's cardiovascular or energy systems work. When you're putting someone on a bike like this, you can put a beginner on and just require them to put it all or nothing into it. It doesn't matter. It doesn't take a high level of skill. It's very safe, and man, is it gonna beat you up. Then we're getting into these rowers here. Concept 2 makes a great one. I use one from Perform Better as well. They're terrific. Again, you can demand a lot out of the body. They're incredibly lightweight. They're much less expensive than, say, a treadmill might be, and they store pretty easily. So I know at my club, Drive 495, when I had it open, we had those in there, and now in my home, yes, I do have these rowers. Okay, getting into our ski ergs. This is like a, this is what I like to refer to as a vertical rower. Okay, it still runs off of that same fan belt. Again, it can require us to put a lot of effort into something that's very safe, very space friendly, and it's not requiring a high level of athleticism to perform. And I think a lot of times when we're bringing people into the gym and there's that, you know, amount of time it takes to teach them to perform, say, a kettlebell swing or a proper sprinting form, which I'm always working on. I lean on my friend Derek Hansen for that. You're gonna find a modality like this is really a great way to be able to take a person at any fitness level and allow them to place their foot on the gas, all right? I'd probably say one of the most user-friendly cardio modalities out there would be the sled. I use sleds from Perform Better. This one is fantastic as well. I mean, I wouldn't overthink it too much, but what I like about it is we're really requiring the entire body to have to create tension, okay? Get into a good athletic, safe position, all right, while we are challenging our heart rate. And for those of you who haven't pushed a sled out there, you're gonna realize that it is pretty damn difficult if you're not used to doing it. But we can push sleds where we're going super heavy and slow. We could do more speed work where we're actually lightening it up. I recommend everyone, if you have access to one at a gym, get on it at least one day a week. Remember though, if you're not used to sprinting, if you're not used to pushing, these are things that we really want to break into. And that's one of the reasons why I love the sled so much, is you can really require, you can determine your own speed. And you don't have to get on there, and it's, if you're just starting off, go a little bit easier. And in time, you can really start monitoring the amount of load that you're putting on the sled, as well as your intensity. I've seen young kids doing relay races with sleds, and they're able to, certain ways to kind of gamify all this where they can quantify their success and their progress. So one of the reasons why I absolutely love it. Getting into probably, if you were to ask me, one of the best tools that I've used in my career is the kettlebell. Okay, and what I love the kettlebell so much is because we can work on strength, we can work on power, we can work on mobility, but we also can work on a lot of endurance. And I think when you are, but it also takes a level of skill, and you have to learn how to swing a kettlebell. I offer a kettlebell course with Dr. Chris Holder with Perform Better. And for those of you wanting to learn, I suggest, you know, paying attention to my social media, giving Perform Better a follow, and seeing when we're gonna host that one-day course. It's a one-day course. We're adding so much value into one day, and we're teaching the swing, the squat, the clean, the snatch, the military press, and the get-up. It's the big six, okay? But as for cardio modalities, the one area, I think the master of all kettlebell moves is the swing. I mean, we gotta learn the swing first, and that's something that I've been able to burn and torch boatloads of fat off of my clientele, especially a lot of these superheroes that have to travel for movies, they have to film, etc. And being able to throw a kettlebell in their car and be able to go travel and perform all those different components of fitness with one piece of equipment, I think is so invaluable. All right. Also, just looking at it right now, we have space. Okay, sprint work, jumping, bounding, allowing the body to move athletically is something that I feel so many of us stay away from. And when we go into the gym, we want to jump on things like leg presses, which I still think have its value, but we need to be moving like athletes. And if we're not moving like athletes and all we're doing all day long is sitting, that's no bueno. All right. That's something that, you know, in time our bodies are going to get tight. They're going to start developing restrictions. That's how injury happens. And that's how, you know, our ability to be active and have a high level of energy and move the way we used to move as kids is something that I believe every human being should want to do. Now, do I still like things like, I haven't talked about step mills, meaning, you know, stairs, ellipticals, cross trainers, those things. Do I still like those? Absolutely. I like those. I will incorporate more of that in for, say, my steady state cardio. And when I am designing cardiovascular programs, I like to break it down in three really simple approaches. My HIIT style of training, which is high intensity interval training, and that is where I can maintain an extremely high level of speed for a short period of time. My medium state intervals, which might be more of my 30 on, 30 off, my 1 minute on, 1 minute off, and just getting that on repeats. And then my slow, steady state training might be where my heart rate is between 120 to 150 beats a minute. And I can use any modality, like say a treadmill, I can use an elliptical, I can use a step mill, but I'm probably not gonna use something like a kettlebell, because that, how I like to teach the kettlebell, might be more of a hard style fashion where I'm trying to require the body to just give a maximal amount of output in a short period of time. So as you can see, I have different tools for different approaches. All right, guys, remember, this isn't everything out there. This is what I like to use in my training. If you guys have any questions, please fire them off to me below. Thanks.